Hey guys, James with Major OSC here, making a video to show you the piano sounds that are going to come with the Superwave patch collection for the Novation Summit. And that's going to consist of 128 presets, singles, and then 128 more multis that will have all sorts of crazy stuff in them. And boy, I'm having fun making the last of these multis. I'm about 75% done with the multis. The singles are completely done. And I wanted to get the singles done in case I wanted to draw upon some of those for the multis. But what you're about to hear, these are all constructed from scratch as multis. And what I liked about using multis for piano sounds is that it gives you that additional flexibility. True, you're limited to only 8 voices because, you know, it's 8 per layer, 2 layers. But it really helped with getting some of those subtle nuances that a piano tends to exhibit. So without further ado, this is going to start with a basic piano. This is the first one I did, and then it's going to get progressively more complex and kind of different. So I think the last one I did was a grand piano. I think that was the best one that I did overall. I think that one's the most realistic sounding and the most kind of, it has all those nuances that you'd kind of expect out of a piano. But you decide. You take a listen and let me know. You already heard the intro, I'd imagine. So this is the first piano I did. 2 layers. That's the low, gets kind of the muffled sound. Really helps with up top. And then here's the other one, other sound. That has those kind of harsh overtones. As you can tell, down low, it's still too muffled. You want to have that kind of sound. That's not exhibiting it. So I started over to try to figure out some different ways of getting that sound without making this sound like a clavinet or some kind of funky harpsichord or whatever the hell those are called. All right, next one, Piano 3D. This is kind of that one I just showed you, except with some more effects and some minor tweaks. Okay. Now you might be asking, why would I add effects to a piano sound? Well, I'm a big fan of the Korg M1. I never actually owned one, but I very much liked the Korg Legacy Collection, the digital, and that would include the M1 and the Wave Station. And there's a lot of these kind of hybrid sounds. And there's a lot of these in all over the M1. There's just, I think there's a whole bank of them. Anyways, yeah, this one, that was a fun one. There's this is Piano Maximo. This one's good for kind of stabs. Next one, I called this I'm sort of piano. So I really got those low, got that low end nailed down. Maybe not all the way down, but pretty lower than usual. But it's funny, you play one of these, it sounds kind of buzzy, not quite realistic. Play an octave. Rusty playing my Tears for Fears. We got to work on that one. All right, let's move on. This is Coldplay Hybrid. You can guess what this one is going to entail. Oops, an octave too high. Thank you. thirsty at that one too, apparently. That one is very, very echoey, or, you know, a lot of ambience. And I'm probably going to have a yet to add some animate buttons to kind of reduce that, or some alternate modes. If you own the Summit, you know this thing has a phenomenal reverb, so, you know, had to make a couple of piano patches with taking advantage of that. This is I think I actually left this one the way it was because the next one, Grand Piano, is kind of the brighter, more full. Screwing up. Wait, that one's an easier song to play, but I can still do Charlie Brown, your theme, better. All right, next up, we're going to go over some electric pianos. This one is the most basic. EP is me, it's called. I think I took inspiration from DX7 and the Doogie Howser theme. And I cannot play that one, so I'm not going to. I'm not even going to try. Okay, I tried. Move on. Law and Orderific, this one was called. Oh, gotta play it right though. I can't play that shit. Next one. This one's called Hefner. Fan of Mitch Murder. All bit swayed. These are all a little similar, but different variations. And mod routings for the mod wheel and stuff. Just depends on what the intention was. This one's called Infinite Pleather. Soul. This one is named after a Dave Weckl album. Dave Weckl is a drummer I studied after school for about three to four, well, not studied with. I studied, as in listened to, transcribed, and et cetera, et cetera, for drum lesson homework. And there's an intro on his Rhythm of the Soul album that sounds a lot like this. Dynamics are not that pronounced, so let's reduce that. And here too. There we go. There you go. A lot easier to play. Oh, okay, that's it. Might as well show you this one. This one has an arpeggiator going up top. You just hold a chord. You move the mod wheel up. Probably going to do is put in an expression pedal for the filter on this one. I know not all of you have expression pedals, but should be using one because it's just one more element of control to use with this, you know. And aftertouch is a bitch to really get down sometimes, so not always practical either. So yeah, think about getting one, because I'm going to have plenty of presets, I think, with mod wheel routings added. Okay, we're going into the regular presets at this point. Those are the pianos, and really stoked to finally get this finished, but I'm taking my time as I have a few more days. And unfortunately, I lost my day job due to coronavirus, and much more recently too. It wasn't months ago, it was just recently, about a week and a half ago. So my new day job is finishing this and probably starting up another collection for the DeepMind, and finishing the second follow-up to the ASM Hydrosynth. So a lot going on. We'll see where the hell I end up for day jobs in a few months. But, you know, there's a little extra bonus for being unemployed. So we're going to be just fine until then. Anyways, thanks for watching. Watch out for another preview. I'm probably going to post another just before it's launched. But yeah, early June. Superwave will be available for the Novation Summit. Oh, one more thing I wanted to show you guys. I thought this is kind of neat, and it's a good example of how I really, really strived for realism on these pianos. Check out when you play the high notes. The decay is kind of short. play the low notes, decay is much longer, just like a real piano. One of many subtle nuances you can expect out of the pianos in the Superwave collection.